you so much for inviting me back to your beautiful home, the Academy. And a special thanks to Shirley Berg, the Artistic Director, for organizing this event and making it all happen. Another special thanks to my piano teacher, Dr. David Korovar, for helping me foster my musical voice and helping me along with my musical journey for the past 5 years. It's been, I think, almost exactly 1 year since I have performed here last year for my first solo piano concert. And for those of you who weren't there, thank you so much for coming. My name is Jakub Berlov. I am 17 years old and a junior at Boulder High School. And I'm so happy to be performing, sharing my music with you all tonight. One thing I really love about the Academy and this chapel in particular is the intimacy between the performer and the audience. And it, to me, resembles what the European salons were like in the 17, 1800s. And the first piece I'll be performing tonight, the Mozart Piano Sonata in C minor, was specifically written to be performed in spaces just really similar to this. And despite the fact that this sonata is one of Mozart's most ambitious, most virtuosic sonata, it can be played in any concert hall. I'm so happy I'll be able to share this with you in a space Mozart envisioned it to be performed in a beautiful place like here. So without further ado, I hope you enjoy the Mozart Piano Sonata number 14 in C minor.
Thank you. Thank you.
next pieces I'll be playing are three pieces by Claude Debussy, Masque, Gambardier, Disquise, and Muse Joyeuse. These three pieces, although they are separate, they're not in an established set. They're often played together because they share common musical ideas, styles, and themes. And the first piece, Masque, by Debussy, is very heavily inspired by Le Comédien de l'Arte, which was an early form of professional theater originating in Italy, and it was commonly enjoyed in Europe throughout the 16th and 18th centuries. And this type of theater was generally performances that were inspired by sketches or scenarios, and they were generally improvised. However, the most, I think, iconic aspect of the Comédie de l'Arte was the use of masks. That's the title of the piece, Masks. Where they would put masks, theater masks, on their head, and it would be used to exaggerate the characters, usually for comedic effect. And this piece definitely exemplifies the excitingness of the theater. But it was also written while Debussy was separating from his wife, so there's a little bit of tragedy in there as well. The next piece, Don Cahier, is translated to from a sketchbook in English. And there are not many performances of this piece. It's not very widely played, but it's so beautiful. There's so many different magical realms in this piece. He plays a lot with color, and it's just beautiful. One interesting fact about this piece was that Ravel, another French impressionist composer, was with the music of Don Cahier, and he's like, I want to compose like this. So this piece was a very big inspiration for Ravel. The last, Muse Joyeuse, translates to A Joyful Island. It is one of the most, I think it is the most well-known of the set, and it is inspired by a painting by Jean Watteau, the 17th century, I believe. His painting, Le Marquement au Citer, and this painting is a depiction, translates to the embarkment of Cypra. And Cypra, in this painting, is a Greek island, and it is supposed to be the birthplace of Venus, the goddess of love. And in this painting, you can see a happy group of revelers. There are French aristocrats who are arriving to this island, just having a great time. There are Cupids flying around, and it's full of magic. And this piece very exemplifies the gaiety of that painting. This piece is full of suspense, magic, love, and happiness, and much more. So I hope you enjoy these three pieces by Claude Debussy. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. It's working.
So the next piece I'll be performing is the Chopin Fourth Ballade. And there's pretty much nothing I could say about this piece besides the fact that, in my opinion, it's one of the most beautiful pieces ever written. And it tells stories of love, tragedy, madness, and the human soul. composer. He lives in New York and he's in his 60s. This piece is both not only terrifying to the audience, but terrifying to play as a pianist. So hard. And he got the name Gargoyles after he composed the piece, so, but it definitely feels like Gargoyles. It's grotesque and ethereal at some times. But the first movement tells of a, I think it's a really wicked, gargoyle, and very cunning and aggressive. The second one is, seems quite lonely to me, but still creepy in its own way. The next movement is very ethereal and magical. It seems like a gargoyle from another world. And then the last one is just very, 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 not only for the audience.